and I will do it for you.
Hi guys, can you imagine that this wish can turn into a beautiful woman? Well, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Yuli Fitriani. I am from TBI 4C. Today I'm gonna tell you a legend of Tubalik. Once upon a time, there was a diverse village in a faraway island called Sumatra. In northern part of the island lived a farmer whose name was Tuba. He lived alone in a hut by a small forest. One day, he wanted to catch some fish, so he went to a river and fished there. He was very surprised when he caught a big fish. The fish was as big as a human being. Soon he went to home and put the fish in his kitchen. He planned to cook and eat the fish for his dinner that night. Then, as he walked into his bedroom after taking a bath, Tuba was very shocked. Do you know what happened? There stood in his living room a very beautiful girl. The girl greeted him nicely. For a moment, Tuba was very speechless. When he could control his emotion, he asked her, "Who are you? What's your name? Why suddenly you are here in my house?"
"Pardon me if I surprise you, Mr. Tuba, but you took me here. I was the fish that you caught in the river. Now that I become a human being again, I would like to thank you, and I will be your servant to express my thankfulness."
"Were you are the fish?"
"Yes, I was the fish. Look at your kitchen."
Tuba immediately rushed to his kitchen, and the fish was nowhere to be seen. He saw some gold coin instead.
"Whose are coins are these? Why there are some coins here?"
"Those coins are mine. As I change into a human being, my scales into a gold coin."
"Okay, you can live here and work for me. Your room is over there."
"Thank you very much, Mr. Tuba."
Since the day, the beautiful girl lived in those Tuba house. And not long after that, Tuba falling in love with her, and they got married.
"Can you marry a doctor and make my wife?"
They got married. The girl married Tuba in one condition, that he would never tell anybody about her past. Tuba agreed to the condition. Several moments later, Tuba's wife delivered to a baby boy. Their son is healthy. Soon, he grew up into a handsome boy. Tuba named him Samosir. Unfortunately, Samosir was a lazy boy. He did not want to work all at. When his father worked hard in his rice field and farm, Samosir just slept. When he was awake, he took a load and ate a load. Tuba was very disappointed with his son's nature. He hoped that one day Samosir would change into a diligent boy. Day in, day out, but Samosir never changed. Tuba used to go to his farm and rice field early in the morning. Then, at midday, his wife would bring him food. To use to go to his farm and rice field early in the morning, then at midday, his wife would bring him food. They used to eat lunch at their farm. As he was a teenager, Tuba and his wife tried to change his behavior. They ordered Samosir to bring the food for his father for lunch. while her mother stayed at home to do household chores. But Samosi never did his duty well. He always wake up very late. He woke up after midday. Then one day, his mother forced him to bring the food. Sam, wake up! Go to the farm and bring the food for your father. He must be very hungry. But Mom, I'm very tired and hungry too. What are you tired? You just wake up. Go now. Your father needs the food. Toba reluctantly went to the farm, but he did not go to the farm immediately. He stopped somewhere in the street and ate the food. It was already late after when he got to the farm. His father was disappointed. Then he was angry as he realized that his sons had eaten the food. He said sarcastically, "Oh, you are so lazy, boy. You are a son of fish." Samosi was hurt. He went home right away, and as he got home, he told his mother about his father's work. Samosi's mother is shocked. She was also deeply hurt. "Oh, Toba, you break your promise. So I cannot live with you here anymore. Now you have to accept the consequence of what you did. Samosir, now go to the hill. Find the tallest trees and climb it."
"Why, Mom? What will happen?"
"Just do it. Never ask any question. Goodbye."
As soon as she finished saying that, suddenly the weather changed. Sunny day suddenly turned into cold day. Not long after that, the rain poured heavily. The rain lasted for several days. Consequently, the area was flooded. The whole area became a big lake. Then it was called Lake Toba. And in the middle of the lake, there is an island called Samosir. Meanwhile, Toba's wife disappeared.
Okay, that's all a story about the legend of Toba Lake. Then, the moral message from the story. Number one, if you have promise, we should keep it. Number two, we must continue to maintain speech even when we are emotional. Number three, we must be more patient in all conditions. And the last, we must be forgiving people. Okay, that's all for me. Thank you for your attention. And the last, I say wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And I will do it for you. For you. Baby, I'm not moving on.